We'll be right back. I'm back here. Craziness in life right now. What's up, Austin?
Okay, sorry about that. Man, that was, how long was that? 30 minutes, oh my god. How's it going, one and all? How's it going? I've got a sliver. Ah. Yeah, my landlord got... Right when I went live, my landlord arrived. He wanted to get all the sprinklers... He wanted to check all the sprinklers in the yard to make sure they're going and stuff. So we had to go turn each station on one at a time, make sure they're all running. And the sliver... pissing me off. So, what's going on? Oh, I was gonna do a okay. I haven't done anything on the streaming for a while, have I? Public. Man, that... The last time I did a Killplex's streaming video on YouTube, I left it up for like a week. When I used to do that, like, even if it was left up for like that day, someone would be like, hey dude, your streaming video's still up. Like, oh crap, thank you. A week went by, no one said a thing. And I didn't even notice for a whole flipping week. And I'm like, okay. So that, it's like Killplex is streaming for an entire week. So all these people seeing it, just being like, oh, let me go look, and then it's just offline. Man, I can't get this dang splinter out. Master splinter. Yo, that's... Oh, I got it. No? No. Speaking of master splinter, that Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle game comes out sometime soon, doesn't it? Is it on Steam? Actually, isn't it just called Oh. Yeah, that's it right there. Summer of 2022. Yeah, this game looks flippin' rad. You can play freaking April and Splinter, man! I am going to rip my finger to bits, try and get this son of a bee out. I'm thirsty. I turned that down enough. Yeah, okay. That time of the year when it's like heater during the night, AC during the day. It's so annoying. Bro. These tweezers are not cutting it. Oh my... God. I had my slippers on. They have hard soles, so they're kind of like shoe slippers, but still, walking around on wet grass in those, it's kind of got soaked through and crap, and it was gross. I hate that feeling. Stream's canceled, dude, until I get this sliver out. Oh my God. It won't. Oh my God, wait a minute. 15 minutes ago when Chester Print donated $50. Hello? Did anybody see that 15 minutes ago? Is that right? Bro.
My record goes unbroken. Also, rip.
Birdman, thank you so much for your resub. Dude, $50, dude, though. Thank you so much for the donation, man. Need a microscope. Oh my God. I guess I just live with this now. God, I hate it. Wonder how I got it. What is wrong with these tweezers? What is your purpose? What are you made for exactly? Plucking eyelashes? Like, come on, man. It won't. It won't. Like, it'll press against it so that, it, like, you get that gross feeling that splinters give you. But it won't actually just grab and pull. Oh my God, dude. Oh my God. Fuck you. No, it's not the wrong side. I know which way it's poking out. I don't get it. Like, I'm using a freaking pin needle, whatever these things are called, and I'm flipping, stabbing it, and like trying to dig it out even, and it's not working. So, how'd you guys spend your Saturday? Dude, that's the first time when Chester Burns talked in chat? Are you serious? Is it wrong? You've donated so many times, bro. First time chatter, no. Did I get it? Wait, did I get it? I can't tell. I think I did? I'm not getting that feeling anymore. Man, that must have been a little flippin' piece. No, it's still there. Ah, there it is. Yeah. I think I got most of it. Well, whatever. My body will push it out eventually, right? At least it's not irritating me when I rub my finger over it, so. How annoying.
While I put these headphones on, did my head shrink? The frick?
I think I put it on my headset, my VR. I think that's why it's. Yeah, link the video. Yeah, it'll open up and flip an OBS all weird like. You know what's bizarre? I'm like, I had I've been like, is craving even the word? I've been like wanting to like give Dragon Age Inquisition another go. And I just own like the base game. And on Steam today, well actually I don't know how many days. It's on sale for $8. It's originally like $40. It's like the Game of the Year edition. So it has all the crap. So I'm like, okay, I'll just buy this then. I've tried this game twice now, and I can't even get past like the first area. What am I doing wrong? Or what is the game doing wrong? Like, what's the fun class? That's the one that's been eating away at me. I've been like Googling it and researching it. It's like Dragon Age Inquisition, funnest class. And everyone says, like, different things. Just don't know. Both times I tried a warrior, two-handed warrior, and I guess I didn't care for it. And I'm trying to do a rogue class. Yeah.
There's a part two? I guess the other one did say part one, didn't it? Wait, so I did this. I've completed that quest. Okay, I'm gonna go with, like,
oh, this is low-hanging fruit. Isn't this cyberpunk?
Let's see what happens.
Oh my gosh! I'm literally holding my finger out like a pistol.
I forgot all about this.
Spirit gun.
I forgot about this.
I'm really hyped for the new Yu Yu Hakusho live action show that's coming on. I don't dare vault though. I'm afraid it'll break the animation.
Excuse me? There's a Yu Yu Hakusho live action show, or am I just making that up?
I don't dare vault though. I'm afraid it'll break the animation.
Like, it shoots, doesn't it? And he, like, actually recoils.
Oh, they're reacting like I'm shooting them, too.
Oh.
Oh, that's fantastic. I don't want this to be a glitch. I want this to be permanent. Illegal activity? I'm not doing something illegal. I'm just finger gunning.
Can you really not kill civilians in this game? God, this game.
Oh, kill him! He's got a finger gun. Crime reported. Oh yeah, pew, pew. You'll never take me alive. Pew, pew. Pew, pew. No, they're not playing. I'm just playing. I thought that we were just playing around. Those are real bullets. Ah.
Oh god. Gentleman's application.
Back to conversing normally. Oh my gosh, that was funny. Oh, please help me, please help me, please help me.
Oh, oh. Yeah, I forgot about this.
Excuse me, why is there a zombie in you? What is happening?
Someone clip that, please.
Johnny Bravo heads. It's like Johnny Bravo, two of them to the right.
Vegeta, what happened, man? I heard a game came out. Where did it read out of? Did it read out of? What? I heard it out of.
Man, my landlord saw my setup in here and he's like freaking out. I have like all these screens.
I've been fine. Busy with work. How are you?
Alright.
I came in like a for the autoplay, bitch. I hate YouTube's autoplay. Boy do I. Let's go into bullet time while I aim like that. Just to emphasize this.
You know what's funny is it still does this. Like, if you replay the game, at this part, it always does this.
Kill shot.
Like, they never fixed it.
What are you doing? Those don't work indoors. Those don't work indoors. He was trying to mortar strike me.
Oh, it worked indoors! It worked indoors! It worked indoors! I streamed flipping this game? I don't remember streaming this. I only saw episode one of Kenobi so far. I haven't watched two and three. I freaking binged the hell out of Stranger Things, though. My gosh, yeah. That series. I can't just watch one episode and, like, alright, I'll watch another one later. I just have to watch all of it. That puddle right there should just be like growing.
Wow, the frame rate should be too bad.
Don't give me a game! Don't give me a game! It minimized! Hello? Why does Steam minimize your game when you get a game?
God, that is stupid! When was this? God, I don't remember anything of that happens in my life. Imagine liking Star Wars. Imagine liking a popular thing that billions of people like. Just imagine. Lamal.
Holy F, my frame rate has tanked 30. Is it a different app?
Snap.
What's it called?
Gosh.
How do you do it, chat?
I'm old already.
Oh, come on, you're all trendy Snapchat users. How do you do it? Oh, wait, is that me?
Oh yeah, I took a picture of myself, didn't I? What the hell was that?
Sorry about this. Boy, he ain't happy when he's like, "Fuck you, man. Hey, you know what? F you! I was trying to flip him off with his finger."
This whole flipping section was a freaking. Gosh, if I was still a motivated man, I was gonna make a whole video about that one part. Because, man, that was chaos and hilarity. He finally talks.
No! God, that's my life. God!
The whole zoom. Nice.
sipping rubber banding. No, wait. Listen, the sound effects are so... Like, that sound is perfect. The flipping, like, what even is it? Like rubber, like balloon rubber sound? That's the perfect sound effect.
No joke, no doubt about it. His hand was up his butt.
Oh! Let's just show you what happened. I was so confused. Here's what happened, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, here's what I did. Spot the problem. It said I was 245 BMI. And I was like, excuse me? 245 BMI. Obese class. I'm like, what? But, I need to put 5'9".
1'9"? He like goes back to his hurt animation after ragdolling. Oh, is that, that's his goatee. I thought that was his mouth. I thought he was like, ugh. Okay, that's his goatee.
That's the kind of bugs I'm watching out for. Oh.
Oh,
I thought I lost the camera movement. Yo, help me.
That's a nightmare.
Good God, what have you done, and why did you do it? Camera movement is locked. Well, I don't want it locked. I want it unlocked. Oh, God, I broke everything. All right, reset. 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 Help. Emergency. Why can't I reach it? Hello? Oh, no. Oh, God, no. Help. HUD visible, game unpaused, crash game, and we're good. All right, now let's get to taking photos. God damn it. I don't know what happened.
Self-impalement. God, I can't believe I played in that tiny room.
They glitched and they impaled themselves.
Boy, nothing wrong is gonna go bad. Nothing bad's gonna go wrong. How? How the mother F are you supposed to survive that? Hell, why is his face doing that? What the crap? This is so bizarre that I never noticed his face. What the heck
is this? This game broke. Not the game. This freaking version is busted. It's just broke.
Is that the one that went fast forward on me too?
You can't see what's going on my screen. Everything is broken. Good thing the stream's ending. In fact, I'm gonna show you the webcam. Look at this! Look at what's going on right now. It's like... the chat's like doubled here and like OBS things here and like... if I move OBS, watch what happens. It's like... Oh, God. Oh, oh, oh.
Okay.
And that, look, it's repeating the chat here.
Look, what the here's frick?
Chat, here's chat. Here's chat. Here's chat. What the hell is going on?
What the
I'm
hell?
Surrounded by chat.
That's crazy.
They got four chat windows. What is going on? Oh my god.
This is the magic world of technical nonsense.
Yuck. What? What is this? Oh wait, no, I remember this.
I got a surprise for you. Listen up real close, okay? You smell that? I feel much better now.
Who linked that? Who linked that? VHS. What? Why? Why?
Look at them all practically leading.
Hang on.
No.
Nope.
I don't think you actually uploaded this one for me. Because I would totally put this on my channel. I don't think that you uploaded this one for me to download. I know you've shown me this. I remember watching this. I just, when I told you to link me all your montages so I could upload them as a fan edit on my channel, I don't think you did this one. Maybe you did and I'm just an idiot.
Dad? Dad?
Whoa, this is officially getting VR support. On PSVR. Like, I legitimately am going to get a PSVR because no one's supporting VR right now. No one is. I'm the only one. PSVR is the only one supporting VR. Like, Sony. So I guess I'm going to get a VR headset because I need to support this freaking platform because it's dying, gosh dang it. I mean, they're doing the flipping Resident Evil 4 remake and they're putting that in VR. Modern Warfare 2 is getting VR? The new one?
Timing of that!
Or like the old one?
Better.
I did not see that. For what?
This is me after my weekend of barbecue, to be honest.
That fart too tall wave. It goes through every fart sound effect. Oh, like, just slowly plays each one. PSVR 2, wow. So they're, like, geez, truly I am getting... When does PSVR even come out?
Okay, I'm okay. Holy frick.
It never ends.
They had a state of play Thursday. More than half of the game announcements were VR. And they didn't announce when the headset was coming out. That's freaking weird, actually. It was seriously like 90% VR games.
It's dying out!
And they didn't say when the VR headset's coming out.
Upstairs in the house.
Demon's dead!
I say dying!
Wait, what?
I got him.
Okay, now I'm completely gone. Where are we going?
Oh,
Jesus Christ.
Oh, it was Dino.
Oh, yeah, Dino.
There is no E3 anymore, my friend. But Summer Game Fest is next week, isn't it? Which is the new E3. Yeah, it starts next week. Yeah, but the thing is, like, why would Sony do their own state of play, show all their VR stuff, and then show the VR at the frickin' Summer Game Fest with Jeff Keighley? That's weird.
Jesus Christ, I feel like
maybe they will. Yeah. That's weird, though.
I need it.
Bro, I mean, you can mod. You can actually can mod Resident Evil 8 to run in VR on PC. I don't know how well it runs though. I'd rather do it. I'd rather play natively than a mod.
God.
Like, I don't know. Maybe the mod runs really good. Maybe I should just play the VR version on PC. But I don't know how well the mod runs.
Wow, we just stumbled upon.
Oh my gosh, chat, what if we just stumbled upon? Oh my gosh! We found a treasure trove! Oh! The cool thing about the official version is that you can dual wield. You like dual wield pistols and knife and pistol, but I mean that might make it a little easier. I mean, of course it will. The thing is it's not coming out on. It's not officially coming out on PC. We know this now. Like, Resident Evil 7 got VR on PlayStation 4, and that never came out on PC ever. Never came out on PC. So we know for a fact it's not. But. No. I was going to say, but Sony's doing a lot of PC stuff, but it's a Capcom game. I'm thinking Sony paid, like a heavy chunk of money to get exclusivity of the VR. And of course they're not going to port it to PC, because they're wanting to push the PSVR. So they're not going to... It's exclusive. Just like Resident Evil 7 VR, it's going to be exclusive to the system forever. Which sucks.
What have we found on YouTube? We found it, we deep dived. I'm not watching these yet. Remember this for future reference.
Yeah, that's so annoying too. Cause Resident Evil 4 Remake, I'm gonna wanna play the PC version of that. But then I wanna play the VR version of that, which will only be on PS5. God, that's gonna suck. That is gonna suck. Because I will not play that game natively. On PS5 with controller. With a shitty controller? I will never play a Resident Evil game. A third-person Resident Evil game on a controller? Hell no. That's mouse and keyboard. Must play on mouse and keyboard. So, I won't even play Resident Evil 4 on PS5 until the VR version is released. Because it didn't say it's coming out with... It said, like... VR version in the works, so I'm guessing Resident Evil 4 Remake will come out, and then probably a year or even more later, the VR version will get released, so then I'll buy the game then, which will suck, because I'll have to buy the game twice. That sucks ass.
Just type Doom Fart. That's all you need to find, is Doom Fart. There.
Dang it. I just wanted to watch this part, because this always, always, always will crack me up. Here it is.
One. Yeah! We're doing it! Oh!
Like when you're just editing a video and then just suddenly fart noise. And then the realization of why. Good job, Austin. There is a goddamn, the neighbor's got a new dog and it's just right there against my fence, their fence. And it's just, can you hear it? It doesn't shut up. It just barks. And it doesn't shut up. And it just barks and barks. And it doesn't shut up. That makes it funnier. And I love, whenever I'd laugh hard, Jinjo would always freak out. She'd like think I was dying or something. You can't hear it? Here, listen, listen close. Listen close now. Can you really, though? Because I have a compressor filter, so I don't know that you'll be able to hear it. You know what you will be able to hear? The neighbors that way. They bought two peacocks. Two peacocks. And do you know how loud peacocks are? Do you know how often they go, ah! Do you know? They do that a lot. So I got right here. Oh, and then this neighbor. Oh my God, I'm surrounded. These neighbors have the dog right up against my fence. This neighbor literally uses my backyard because my landlord lets him. Has a horse there that just screams. So there's a horse in my backyard always going, like all the damn time. And then the neighbors here bought two peacocks, and they're always going, ah! And that is my freaking life in this house. So we got woof woof, horse screaming, two peacocks yelling at each other. It's a damn zoo. I live at a zoo.
Stop!
Okay. I am in Utah. What's illegal? Why would peacocks be illegal? When I was younger, we had there was a name when I grew up with peacock sounds because there was a house down the block that always would have a peacock always. So I was used to the, but it was like not a mile. It was down the road, like a block away. So like I always just. That was just a familiar noise for me when I was growing up. But now it's like this dude right here has two. Because they sit and just do it. And sometimes, like at 10 p.m. at night, I'll go into the kitchen to like wash my hands or whatever. And just, I'm like, there's got to be some neighbors like complaining to the police. Right? But then again, no one complains about these assholes with their dog. They've had These assholes next to me, dude. They get a dog, and then they just lock it in a tiny pen outside and leave it, and, like, don't interact with it. Like, it's a new one. Apparently, they just get a new dog every few years to just lock outside and drive it insane, and then, I don't know, kill it and get a new one. I don't know what the hell they do. But this neighbor here, he has horses, he has chickens and roosters and rabbits, and like I'll go outside and there'll be just big old rabbits in my yard hopping around. It's like, all right, or chickens and roosters, and then he's got horses, and that horse, I don't know, he's got one horse that's just like, I don't know what's hitting at, like maturity or adolescence or whatever, not adolescence, if it's like maturing or whatever, so it's like horny all the time and screaming, because it's just pacing and like, Rah! It's just like, God. Animals are great when they're, like, single digits, right? Not even that, like, singular animals. Like, I love a cat. I fucking hate cats. I encounter one cat, I'll love the hell out of it. I love, oh, kitty, pat, pat, pat. Cats, plural? They're like rodents. Like, get, I want to freaking poison them, kill them, and I hate them. That's how I am with, like, any animal. In moderation, they're great. When there's, like, a group of them, like, they're the worst thing. I'm going specifically cats, too, because I grew up with, like, 14 cats at all times at my house. Because my mom, she was the cat lady, but she wasn't really. We had a few kids, but always strays would just adopt our home and live there. So we always had like 14 plus cats all the time. And I just hated it. They were rodents. But yeah, pin to the close winder. Oh, and now it's not pinned to the, god damn. Alright, so I bought Alan Wake Remaster. And I've kind of been in the mood to play that, so why not? I guess we're done with Elden Ring, goodbye. Nah, we're not done with it, but just in the mood for Alan Wake. I'll probably get sick of it. Something will happen. I'm in one of those weird gaming moods where, like, I want to, like, everything sounds good to play, and I just will download it and then play it a few hours and then stop, and then be like, ugh. I hate when I'm in those moods where it's just, like, I want to play, like, everything, but then I do, I'll play a game, and then I'll just not want to keep playing it. I don't know what the hell that is about. It better let me do Nightmare from the get-go, motherfucker. I'm not playing this on normal mode. I'm not. So I guess I'm not playing this tonight, chat, because I need to figure out how to play it on Nightmare. Son of a bitch. Why the fuck do they do this? Why do games fucking do this? I'm not playing it on fucking normal, bitch. Alan Wake Remaster, unlock Nightmare. Nightmare save. Thanks for the resub, Birdman. Wait a minute, no, you already resubbed. Why did it do that? Oh, he gifted a sub to Dwarvakin. Why doesn't that show up in my thing? Oh, there it is. It just popped up. Okay. Oh my god, you gotta get a hex editor to do this. No, come on. Come on, man! I gotta change 1-0 to 1, and that's literally it. So start a game so that a save game is created.
Stephen King's
Carrie. Stephen King's Stranger Things. God, this season of Stranger Things is like, I know people joke and be like, people joke about Stranger Things being like heavily obviously inspired by Stephen King, but this season is just like, it's just like It. They're like, we're out of ideas. Let's just make it an It series and call it Stranger Things.
I could hardly stand my feet.
Also, why not play it on normal? Because it's fucking boring and unsatisfying. I want the challenge. Like, the third-person shooters are always too easy on normal mode. I don't know why, but they always are. Any game. Frickin' Resident Evil games, normal mode, never play it on normal mode. Always a nightmare. Frickin' Max Payne games, never play those on normal mode because they're just piss easy. Alright, I don't even have a hex editor. Where's a hex editor? Oh, Chad, I was gonna show you this shit. I tweeted it out, but look at this crap. This is a flippin' AI that will generate an image based on anything you type. It generates it through through artificial intelligence machine learning. So I could type, I don't know. Freddy Krueger, I don't know how to spell his name, damn it. Dead Space Princess. And it just will generate an image based on that, right? I have this one saved. Watch, look at this shit. It's Asian person screaming at a toilet. Okay? You're not even prepared for this. Watch. Look at this shit. Look at this shit. It's a horror. It's horror. It's literally horror. This bottom right one, my zoom program is being stupid. I can't zoom in. Like this one, like this middle one is like there's an eyeball for a mouth. This one's like horrible. God, look at that one, the far. Oh my god. All right, let's see if this generated. Nope, not yet. Dead Space Princess. Oh, here we go. Nah, it's pretty much just like doing Isaac's suit. This one's kind of sexy though. How about Mario kissing, Stephen King? This is gonna be freaking weird, dude. But this one's just like, this. I can't get over this Asian lady screaming at toilet. This one's insane. Like, keep in mind, it's an AI generating this based off of machine learning throughout the internet, right? Like, it, like, will search through Asian ladies, toilets, screaming. Like, it takes all that into account and will just generate this shit. They're not real people. These aren't even real people, right? It generates this crap based off of just learning algorithms and images. Why would I put Sonic? Mario kissing Sonic? I don't need a machine learning. I could just go to Google for that. And there'll be a million pictures of that on frickin' Google that it would be able to just frickin' rip from. Like, I don't need to do that. Those already exist. That's not Stephen King. What is this one? Look, Mario kissing oh gosh. Oh my god. Looks like he's just shaking his hand. This one's freaking. For some reason, faces are really complex, so it always gets faces wrong. Always. It will always get faces wrong. It's really weird. The website's Dolly Mini right there. Look. Alright, chat, say something that I should type in, like a crazy one. Like, there's no Stephen King here, which is weird. I guess there's not enough Stephen King images to kiss? No, we gotta do a kissing one that will work. Maybe I should do Mario kissing Sonic. Let's see what it does. Because there's so much to freaking get off the internet from this. Get off? God, that's not what I meant. Mario kiss, there's so much to get off to on the internet of Sonic kissing Mario. So much to get off to. What, Shade? Why'd you tag me? Oh, you mean just put Killplix? Oh, I should just do that, huh? I wonder what the hell that would do. Because here what I don't understand if this generates based off of, like, if it searches the internet of images and generates based off of that, or if it's just its own entity program with its own library or just machine learning, right? Maybe that's what it is. It's an AI that just has gone through the internet and has all this information already on it. And so you type it in and it's like, all right, they're searching through what I've learned of these words and then generates based on that. I'm totally going to do Killplix. Or should I do Killplixism? Because that's like the channel name of YouTube. It'll probably just be a lot of... Like, look at this! These are so... These are like almost... Like, look at that one. That Sonic face is almost good. There's so much to gather from the internet of Mario. But there's no kissing. Oh, wait. This is... They're kind of kissing here. Threesome here. This one, he, like, broke up with him and he's crying. This one looks like he just punches him in the face. Pow! He's like, oh! Mamma mia. Alright, I gotta see what just regular old Killplix will do. This might be an error because it's not, like, an actual word. Like, what can it gather from this when there's no, like, unless it, like, has information of YouTube. This might just generate, like, YouTube thumbnails of Killplix, which will just be TTT thumbnails. That's literally all this is just gonna generate. Seriously. Because that's, like, grand majority of my YouTube is just, like, 1,000 TTT thumbnails of all the same thumbnail, just with a different number. All right, I need to read this. Wait, where did it go? Oh, right there. Locate your save file. Open the save file. Look for the hex data that reads 303100 or 303101. If you're... I have no idea what this is even attempting. This is just like logos. It must think Killplix is a logo or something. That's weird. Because this is just like logos. Dude, that's like an actual... Like, that looks like an actual logo of something. How about... Goku... in a tutu. Is that how you spell tutu? Ballerina tutu? It is tutu. Alright, hex editor. Let's get a hex editor. Find my save file. Love it. Oh, wait, where is the save file located? It's in my documents. Remedy. Alright, there's the save game. Load it up in this flippin' hex editor. Oh, I gotta install it first. Oh, shit. I hope I just didn't install some freaking spyware. Because I didn't do custom install. I just did express. Usually these programs have hidden, like, include Norton antivirus. And I did not even look for that. All right, we're looking for... Will it just be here? Is it really that simple? I don't see a 30 even on this. Wait, there's a 30. 30? 31, 0, 0. Okay, okay, okay. The 0, 0 indicates the difficulty level. Wait, really? The 0001 at the end is what is important. That represents the difficulty. If you're playing on easy, it will be 0. Normal will be 01. Well, I'm on normal, so it shouldn't be 00. 30? 31? 00? Maybe because I stop. Wait. Oh, you gotta start normal gameplay. It thinks I'm in the tutorial still. Damn it. Alright, well, let's see what this image generated first. Yo, he's in a tutu! It's Goku! Wearing Gaara's mask for some reason in a tutu. Or a burn victim. Oh, God. It really just can't do faces, man. That looks like it has, like, butterfly wings. Oh, God! I mean, it tried, right? Like, this one especially. Like, that's Goku in a tutu. God, it just cannot do faces. God! Alright, chat, what's another one? Specifically faces. This is, let's try one that's just like a body or something. No, I don't know how you would do that. I like the complex ones. Like Goku in a tutu. Like blank and blank, right? How about sexy lady with big boobs? Alright, I'm going to keep that on the other window while that's doing that. I don't think it does nudity, but just in case. Okay, let's freaking do the stupid tutorial of Alan Wake. Difficulty isn't a new game plus, right? Like, you don't start with your old weapons and stuff, right? It's just start fresh on Nightmare.
Stephen King once wrote,
that's just it, right?
From the crash. I could hardly stand my feet.
Because if it's meant to be a new game plus, then I'll be screwed. But I don't think that it is. You know, I'm sure I could do side-by-sides that would show that
I had to go to the lighthouse.
How much better this looks than the original. Waiting for me there. But this just looks like the original to me. It's been so long since I've played the original, though, so I can't really... Like, my memory isn't accurate.
You don't even recognize me, do you, Ryder? You think you're God? You think you can just make up stuff?
God, you really can't run that long, can you?
Deadline.
It's been a hot minute since I've played this game, though. Like, it really has. At least 5+ years. I realized that the Hitchhiker was a character from the story I've been working on. God, it's probably been... I don't know, when was the last time I played this? Oh, now you can sprint. Only when it's convenient for you. Oh, now he's... I'm a rider, not a runner! This game was originally going to be an open world game. This game went through so much development hell. It's amazing it came out good. Like, the entire town, you were supposed to be able to explore it and prepare for nighttime and get missions and stuff. Sound is right out of Max Payne 1. We'll check the image out once I'm through this. I just want to get through this stupid tutorial. You should be able to skip the damn thing. But you can't.
Was a death trap. I had to get out.
Why did it look up to the ceiling like that? Wait, isn't the sequence, like, really cool? Like, the place is, like, falling apart? Or is that another part of the game? Follow the light.
You are hurt. You should go into the light. You are only safe there. Well done. I have something important to tell you. It goes like this.
For he did doobie 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 hoobie.
That beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
No.
Follow my light. I entered your dream to teach you. The darkness is dangerous. It's sleeping now. When it feels you coming, it will wake up. There's no time. I can only show you the most important thing. This way. There's no time. The Hitchhiker has been taken over by the Dark Presence. You can't hurt him now. The darkness protects him from all harm. Only light can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again.
That's freaking Max Payne's voice as well. Is he in every damn Remedy game? He's in freaking Control. He's in Alan Wake. Can burn the darkness away.
You did it. Now the darkness no longer protects him, but it's still inside, controlling him. He can't be saved. He's still a threat. He is still your enemy. Here, take the gun.
Okay, Max. Now go into bullet time. There's no crosshair. That was janky.
Good. You've done well. Remember what I've taught you. That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
In the nightmare, this is kind of a terrible darkness was taking over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
This is kind of an unintuitive, like, in-your-face tutorial. Usually tutorials are, like, you know, a little seamless within the game. This is just, like, straight up, like, here, welcome to the tutorial.
This is it.
Gotcha. Why are they flying up in the air when they die? What the hell? I'm at to bat trees. Whoa, camera, what are you doing? Why do they do that? I hate that. I thought the first time it did it was a glitch, but every single enemy that dies will like pop up and what? That's not supposed to do that. Is my frame rate too high? Like, what the hell is that? And this tutorial is so blatant. I mean, they're making an Alan Wake 2. Maybe they'll go back and make that open world. Maybe they'll, like, do Silent Hill-esque. Because they said it's their first survival horror game, right? I didn't kill you guys? Oh, it did. They were just silhouetted still. That was weird. Yeah, I'm wondering if it's frame rate related. How many frames am I getting? Every time. That's stupid. Maybe V-Sync will help. I don't know. I hate it. I hate that. That is so distracting to me. All right, we're just at 60, so let's see if it. No! What is that, chat? Every single time. And it's locked at 60, so it's not frame rate related. There's no way that they just let that be and be like, all right. Like, there's no way that's how the game is. There's something wrong. But I have no idea what it could be. I have no idea what it, like, what could I do to fix that? There's nothing I can do. I've limited the game at 60 FPS, which is dumb because it shouldn't be allowed to run at a higher frame rate anyway. It's a modern remaster. And then the cutscenes were 30 FPS.
Baby, just another nightmare. Everything's fine. You dozed off.
Yeah, more than dozed off.
Still waiting for Alan to shout Jason.
Cheer up, handsome. We're here.
He really does look like him, doesn't he? He looks like that kid, whatever his name is. He looks like the goof from Heavy Rain. I didn't even think of that.
Let's act like we're on vacation. Go stand next to that old gentleman there. I want a shot of you with the town in the background.
Sure. I'll even give you a title for the shot. A city boy, moments before he got eaten by a bear.
Moments before he got eaten by an elderly gentleman. There's a serious lack of frickin' ambient occlusion.
Hi.
Do I need to add reshade? Nah, there's too much fog in this game that would F it up.
Deerfest, huh?
There is zero ambient occlusion. What the hell?
You have a lovely wife, if you don't mind me saying. I'm Pat Mayne.
You got a hot wife with nice... Oh, wait a minute. That reminds me of that video image. Super sexy lady. Is there really not a damn ambient occlusion option?
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, I'm Alan Wake.
I won't pretend.
I mean, you can if Nvidia if it's supported, I guess I could see.
Such as yourself, Mr. Wake.
Oh shit, it does support this.
I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host at the local radio station. Any chance I could get an interview?
Look, Mr. Mayne. I'm on vacation.
Oh, it doesn't have MXAO. You gotta add it.
Keep my being here just between the two of us. I'm sure you understand.
Fair enough. You can trust me to be this.
It's not even working.
Track down if you change your mind, though.
It's not even working.
You have a lovely holiday.
Yeah, this isn't even... Oh. It is working. That's annoying. You have to actually add the ambient occlusion filter to NVIDIA's nonsense thing. I rarely use this one because it's reshade's just better. Painterly! We can play this in painterly mode. Now it's truly remastered.
Very nice. I got a couple of really good ones.
God, that tanked the frames.
Made a friend. That's cute.
Right. Yeah?
Hey, bestseller. How's my favorite writer? Are you there yet?
Barry. Yeah. We just got here.
Are the locals giving you trouble? Just say the word and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone, Al.
No, Barry. We're fine.
Great. Great. Just want to make sure you can relax and recharge. How is the place? Has it gotten your creative?
The water looks really nice.
Barry, we're just settling in.
Okay, Al.
Really good reflections.
I'll call back later to make sure you're doing okay. And you call me if there's a problem, okay? Okay. I'm just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry.
You know he's going to be calling you every 5 minutes.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
What did I tell you?
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you, too.
Alan, we're here. Come on, let's get back to the car.
I'm actually starting to... Oh my god, chat, you can't see this image that it generated. You can't see this. I'm sorry, but you can't. Holy shit! Let's see if there's like a tamer one that I can show you. This is like the tamest one. Still probably shouldn't show it. Oh, who cares? I have like 5 viewers. No one's gonna report it. In fact, no one will report this. I'm a tiny streamer. Look, chat. Here's the results. Actually, never mind. That one's completely topless. There's no nipples. Oh my fuck. The faces are horrifying as usual. Like, it's genuinely like big boobed ladies with just horrific faces. Just horror faces. This one's tame enough. Look at this shit. I love how, like, they all have lipstick, right? Like, oh god! I don't care, I gotta show this one. God, it's terrifying! Gosh, I wish I could show this one. It's the one that's topless without nipples, but the face is just... It's absolutely horrifying. My god. Look at the burn victims. It's freaking terrible. Anyway, god, did I show this one? Because this one's tame enough. This one's actually not bad because there's no real face to generate. Like, that one actually looks like it could be real, right? In a way. Oh, I should just have, like, an image generating, but, like, the whole time I play. What's another one? Oh, I closed it. There it is. Did anybody come up with a good one? What if I do, like, Mona Lisa? What if I just do, like, an actual art piece? I'm curious. Well, this game handles minimizing well.
Come on, Slowpoke. You get the full service here.
Whoa. The full service, she says. I don't need VSync on, by the way. I prefer my 120 frames, personally.
I've made all the arrangements.
Woo!
I've read the car.
This game runs well.
Carry the bags. All you have to do is drag your cute butt into the car and enjoy the ride.
Yeah, sounds like you've got
try
a
an animal.
For husband.
All right. I'll do that next.
Yeah, but I got a thing for him. Come on, you lazy bastard. Let's go.
Just drives into the water. Blech.
We need to stop at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord. A Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us. I'll go fill her up while you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes.
Sure.
Alan? Thank you for coming here with me.
I love you too. Go on. I'll promise to behave.
How long ago was this game made?
I'd forgotten there were still places.
Because
like
it ends on a cliffhaner.
Towns where everybody knew
it's
everybody.
Been like 20. I'm obviously not 20, but it's been like 10 plus years with no sequel.
Wake. Oh, God. I am your biggest fan. I know people say that all the time, but I really am.
I'm glad to hear that.
Rose,
I'm looking for Mr. Stuckey. Carl Stuckey?
Carl? Oh, of course, Mr. Wake. He must have gone to visit the restroom. He'll be back in a moment.
That face, though. He's on.
I can't believe it. I've got all your books. I got the cutout from the bookstore when they took it out of the window.
And you keep it here. Well, okay. Good for you.
Right. Sorry for quiet vacation.
I wasn't ready to leave. I needed to find Carl Stuckey to get the key to the cabin.
Break your heart when you have to leave.
Rusty here is no longer human. Nothing but black coffee under a thin layer of skin.
Yeah, that makes two of us.
Do me a favor, Sonny. I could really use a tune right now. Coconut, number 6 in the jukebox. I'd do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad circulation. Yeah.
Are you serious? Coconut again? You disgust me. Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable.
Why does F5 bring that up?
It does that. Huh. Get stuck. Yeah. You need to give it a good solid whack. You put the lime in the coconut, drink them both up. Now that's what I'm talking about, yes!
this is it. I've died and gone to hell.
Oh, God. Come on. Can I change the camera angle? Because, like, my webcam's, like, covering up my character. I'm just gonna steal this thermos, if you don't mind.
Don't go in there, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it, ma'am.
I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find Stucky to get the key and get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache. Overeager fans always did.
Hello? Mr. Stucky?
That's Stucco!
Carl couldn't make it. Unfortunately, he was taken ill. But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Okay.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. And to meet your wife. I insist.
Thanks.
Cauldron Lake is a special place. Very inspiring.
Can you change the difficulty mid-game? Cat, why don't games let... I hate when games don't let you do that. Video commentary? What is that? What is video commentary?
Thanks for the follow.
You got lucky this time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
Even that sounds better than your singing.
Are you all right?
Splendid, splendid! Damn hernia. It swells up like a balloon if I lift anything heavier than a spoon. Yep.
Hey, Birdman, thank you for another gifted sub.
I wish.
Tom. Letter C, S tier.
The Andersons.
Maybe C tier. I don't know.
Musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They wandered off from his clinic at the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Bye, Mr. Wake.
Mission accomplished. The key and the directions.
My hero.
Looks like someone's got a small C. Can't have, hey, you can't say cock without C, bro. You gotta. Yeah. Sounds like you got tiny C problems. I'm thinking.
That diner was a real nut house.
Oh, Birdman's leaving. See you, man. Thanks so much again for the gifted subs, bro.
We're supposed to be on vacation, Alice. I'll figure it out when we get back home. Okay?
Okay. We can talk about this later.
Batman here on KBFF.
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years, not since my last book.
And now the weather. It's gonna be a clear night, so you folks in the big city might want to look up every once in a while and see those stars winking down at you. It gets pretty dark out here, but they'll light your way.
Nice freaking detail popping. It's gorgeous. Remaster, more like re-aster.
Don't worry, honey. I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight.
I know.
Oh, yeah, freaking well right here.
The fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset.
Another beginning also goes back to the time when
this is kind of cool.
Working on Max Payne games. I went to study screenwriting at Theatre Academy of Finland, and I wrote.
It's Payne.
Studying there, and one of them was this horror movie, screenplay for a horror movie that I wrote in Finnish actually, and. The title was Pohjavesi, which translated would be groundwater, but maybe kind of more accurate tonally would be to call it
undertone. This flivver, dude, it's still there.
Elements there that I later decided to steal from myself, and they all ended up as part of the story of Alan Wake.
That is cool, but it's too disruptive for a stream. Man, I'm really digging the water rendering. Who's that on the bottom left? Max Payne? Duh. I can't the sliver. Please. Did that get it? Dug in deep enough for you, bitch? My God! You know what's funny is that I've dug so much into it. I don't know if that's just pain from the hole I've dug in me, or if it's still there. Nah, it has a specific feeling. It has a really specific feeling, and it's still in there. I can't believe it. It's gonna get dark here and my wife's gonna freak out. Wait, is it gone? I can't tell. It's just hurting now. Normal difficulty is the same as hard on the console version. What? Yeah, I actually looked up the differences of normal and hard. And all they did was make it take longer to kill enemies. And so I'm like, maybe I'll just play on normal. Because you know how much of a fan I am of difficulty equals larger HP bars as being the laziest way to raise the difficulty.
The island had once been the site for a love story. Maybe it would be that again.
I hate when games are just like, harder means more health for the enemies. Doesn't have to just mean that. You can do, like, more enemies. Or maybe they use different tactics against you that make it harder. You don't have to just, you know, crank their difficulty or crank their HP bar up. Bro, this thing is throbbing now. And again, I don't know if it's because of the sliver or the hole I've put in me. It's gone. It's got to be gone, right? You're just digging a hole, right?
Come on, honey. Get the door open so we can get a look inside.
He, like, turned to her.
Did you just tell me what to do? You do not tell me what to do.
Great. Now my pointing finger, which is the finger I use to press the button of my mouse, hurts whenever I press the button on my mouse.
Anyone here?
A shoebox filled with books by Thomas Zane sat on the shelf. I'd never heard of him before.
The Deer Fest guests have already started to arrive. Just ran into one on the ferry. Now let's go to the phones, caller. You're on KBFM.
Collecting those things even do? I don't even remember. Is it just like to unlock art gallery crap or something?
The cabin looked like a time capsule from the 60s, or even earlier. For a moment, the oppressive feel of the nightmare I had seen on the ferry returned.
Why was it so loud? God! That was unnecessary.
There had to be a fuse box or a generator somewhere on the island.
Also, it seemed like it cut out. It, like, cut off. Perfectly cut screams. I really feel like I need to install Reshade into this. Like, it feels flat. It looks good, don't get me wrong. I'm just a picky pickler. And I think it could use way more ambient occlusion. I'll live. Remastered out. Came out like last year. It's Epic only, though. That's probably why I haven't heard about it. So it'll be out on Steam probably this winter.
The lights are on! Good work, honey. I'll freshen up a bit and start settling in.
Okay. I'll look around a bit.
Sure thing.
Hey, Winchester Burn, thanks again for the freaking donation, bro! Thanks so much. See you later.
It was a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work. I thought we could be happy here.
Freaking! I know that there's a thing in the thing, but if the game doesn't support it, then it won't do the AO. You're making me do this. Here we go. Here we go! Manage 3D settings. Find the game. Here we go! Why am I saying that? Alan Wake. Of course you don't list it in alphabetical order. That makes too much sense. I clicked add and nothing happened. Why is NVIDIA's control panel the most sluggish piece of shit program? Look at this. It's not even responding. My God, this freaking program is just bad. It's sluggish for you too. It's sluggish for everybody. Like, every computer I've used, it's always this bad. Recently used. Now, wouldn't you think Alan Wake... Oh, there it is. GameF.x4. Wait, is that it? I don't know if that's it. EOS? Pretty sure that's not the EXE. God, where did I install it? It's gotta be. Look at the flippin' icon. That's the Alan Wake icon. Oh, that is. That's totally the Alan Wake icon. Okay, that's it then. All right. Where is it? Where is it? Yeah, there's no ambient occlusion. Because it doesn't have it. I mean, it does, but like... Texture filtering, negative LODs, quality, for refresh rate, power management, OpenGL, frame sampling, feature, monitor technology. Monitor technology? What the hell is that? Max frame rate, low latency mode. It's just anti-aliasing. Oh, ambient occlusion is grayed out because it's not supported by this application. Oh, all right, we're adding reshade. That does it. Reshade. You want ambient occlusion? We're getting it. You're getting it. I'm getting it. We're all getting it. Where is it installed? I don't even know where I installed it. Oh, I think I put an E. Ah, there it is. The problem is that injected ambient occlusion looks bad when there's fog and mist. And this game is like 90% misty and foggy, so it's gonna look bad. That is crazy that it straight up doesn't even have a supported ambient occlusion. That's how little there is. I don't know why they didn't... I'm actually going to search. Alan Wake Remaster Ambient Occlusion. It says it uses HBAO Plus for ambient occlusion via NVIDIA. What? It says that's in the graphical settings. Okay. What? Did I miss? I must have missed a setting somewhere. Can you scroll? There's no ambient occlusion option. Like, what am I missing here? TAA-FXA, that's all anti-aliasing. That's not ambient occlusion. Shadow quality, volumetric terrain. There's no ambient occlusion. Here says the settings options. Wait, is it in display? I thought I looked in display. Wait, that's just my monitor. Resolution, full screen. Because this game looks really flat without it. Alan Wake Remaster, ambient occlusion. There's gotta be, like, if there really is an option and I'm not seeing it, like, I can't be the only one. You have to force it via NVIDIA Inspector. Are you serious? Why? Everything I'm reading, it shows graphics options, and it says ambient occlusion is in the options. And it's not. Like, I'm not missing anything here. There's no other options to click. Unless the shadow option is what they count ambient occlusion. No! It says it's in graphics options. It says ambient occlusion is in graphics options. Resolution, vertical sync. Ambient occlusion's at the top. Bro. You can't do this to me. That is so weird, chat. I'm so confused. Maybe this was like these, maybe these settings are like were released before the game came out. Because this is in... This is in that web... What's it called? PC Gaming Wiki, where it lists like issues the games have. And this specifically has ambient occlusion listed. Force HBAO Plus... I have to download NVIDIA Profile Inspector. Change ambient occlusion compatibility value. What the hell? It's weird because I always hear about NVIDIA Inspector and I've never installed it. Oh my god, maybe this is the original Alan Wake. You're so right. Oh, it is. It is. I'm looking at the wrong thing. Yeah, that's the wrong thing. But, still, all these websites are reporting that ambient occlusion is an option that you can enable in Alan Wake Remaster. Some very confused dudes. Confused. I'm a confused dude. Why is it not supported for this application? I don't care. This is how I play my PC games. If it's not to my liking, then I make it to my liking. What if I do Alan Wake Remaster, no ambient occlusion? I guess we can check out what that image was. What did I even do? Mona Lisa. Are you serious? Like, this one's kind of accurate, but it really didn't get the face. It really didn't get the face. Bro, I don't understand. Every one of these websites say that there's an ambient occlusion option, and I don't have that option. Why? Is there another EXE that you can run it through? Like... Is there a configurator? Maybe I can force it through, like, the INI. In my documents, maybe? Alright, my documents it is.
config. There's a config file. It's definitely Notepad, right?
Nope. It is not.
There's no extension. It just says config. There, it's no .exml or anything. Just config. What the hell? No .ini, nothing. That is bizarre. It's just a blank file with no extension called config. Notepad Plus, maybe?
Okay, no.
Load this. Even Notepad Plus doesn't know what the hell this is. Huh. Roaming? App data? Okay. Where would it be, though? Local or roaming? Oh, it's in local. Oh, that's control. Damn it. Epic? Damn it, just search Alan Wake. I hate that. Thanks for the follow. I'm getting to the bottom of this, damn it. Oh, I know, Dragon Seal. They all say that that has an option of ambient occlusion, of HBAO. All of them do. Anyway, here's our Mona Lisa. Beautiful as always. Oh, there it is. Alan Wake Remaster. It's just a blank config file! You can't do this to me!
That could be a friggin' emote. Guys, friggin' horrifying. You know what they remind me of? They remind me of those, like, scary storybooks with those creepy pictures they always had. You know the one. Why did you just do that, you mother effer? Oh, you're a piece of shit then. That's what's going on here. I don't know, man. Alright, let's do cat. Shave said to do an animal. Let's run cat. Well, I guess I'll just inject some ambient occlusion until it looks awful, and then I have to, like, remove it. Fuck off. Fuck Windows, okay? It is so unintuitive and stupid. And you know what the best part is? Windows 11 is even worse. So, awesome. And you know what? I gotta find the depth and all that good stuff. I love Reshade. I mean, I do, but this kind of tinkering stuff's probably not that fun to watch, to be frank. TBHQ. TBQH. See, look, it would look bad here. Like, ambient occlusion through injection would look bad here. I'm just not going to be able to use it, frankly. Look at that, the depth working from the get-go right out of the box. Wow. I'm shocked. Well, yeah, I knew it. It just bleeds through everything when you have the... when it's through, like, mist and stuff. It's just not gonna look good in this game. Through injection. It would only, like, through natively, it would look amazing. But, like, through injection, it's just gonna inject through mist and stuff. See, look how much depth it gives, right? Look at the depth! Everything gets depth with it turned on. Like, just look at Alan Wake and, like, this, like, between his arms and his torso. Look, it's dark, as it should be when you turn it on. Because there's no light able to reach that area, so it's dark. The grass, look, there's darkness because the sun isn't just going to go through it without any darkness and depth. So it looks good. But then you go like this, and, like, it's kind of, like, hazy here, and then it just bleeds through, and you can just see the depth. And it, like, doesn't look good because it's supposed to be, like, blurry right here. And that's how the entire game is going to look, because most of this game is foggy and misty. So it's all going to just bleed through the environment like that, and it's just going to look bad. And it sucks. It sucks. In, like, AO's great injecting as long as it's not foggy and misty. If it was native, you know, built into the game, then obviously it wouldn't be an issue because it's not injected. So, shit. This game needs AO really bad, and it bugs me. God, just look at that. And then I could... oh, I don't have the RT one. I could... I should install the ray tracing. This game would probably look really good with a ray tracing. What if I turn both AOs on? Ultra depth! Blah! God, I am curious how the ray tracing injector would work on this. Now, and it works especially for things like this. See, like, look at the flipping dresser, and look at the floor. Between it and the floor, notice the darkness and the shade? That looks... right, that looks correct to your eyes, right? When you turn it off, it gets lighter. Like, that's ambient occlusion. It's darkness where darkness should be. Like, look at the logs. Oh, look. Where light's hitting it, or where light's not hitting it, it's dark. Because there's no light reaching that area. It works best for, like, underneath things and corners and, like, crevices. Like, even the chair, right? Look, it even gives the indication that it's on the floor instead of, like, it looks like it's just floating above the ground right now. Turn it on. Oh, look. It looks kind of like it's darker there because it's touching the carpet. Fuck! So when there's a lack of AO, it's just really... it looks like an old game, right? It just looks like old and... janky to me. And this is a remaster with supposed HBO and Max Cinemax. Alan, and yet here we are, no porn.
I have a surprise for you.
Oh shit, never mind. Porn coming. Porn coming. I'm coming from porn. I mean, well, yo!
Hello there.
Porn.
No, I'm not the surprise. It's in the study. Go take a look.
Okay.
You're the surprise. You brought a typewriter, you bitch!
Alice? What is this?
I guess I have a small confession to make. I thought maybe you could write here that a change of scenery would get you past...
Damn it, Alice! You... Everyone keeps...
Hey! Just hear me out! There's a local doctor, Dr. Hartman. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
Maybe so now you want to get me committed?
No! It's not like that! That's not... Alan? Alan?
I don't! Just don't! I don't want to hear it! God damn it, Alice! God damn it!
I knew she wouldn't follow me in the dark. I needed some time alone to think things through.
God! Damn! It. Jason! He really does look like that character, doesn't he?
Damn it.
Why is he laughing?
Alice?
Jason? Jason!
Alice!
The cabin had gone dark. All the lights were out.
You know what else I'm noticing is it's not very dark.
Alice, I'm coming! It's all right!
That could just be on me with the brightness settings. That should be barely visible. Are you serious? That is 100% visible. Even at the lowest, it's still plenty visible. So cool, I guess. And the funny thing is, this gauge thing never is accurate, because I'll turn it off and it's just going to be pitch black now.
Coming.
No! That looks alright, actually. That looks way better, actually. What if I just stand there and do nothing? Ow.
What the hell?
Stay away from me!
If a bunch of birds attacked me, I wouldn't go, what the hell?
Alice? Alice? Oh no!
Oh no!
Keep going, Alan. Wake up!
Alice?
Waking up in the crashed car felt like I had woken from one nightmare and entered another. I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice.
Bro, I'm getting no results for people saying ambient occlusion isn't working for them.
The phone was dead. I'd have to find help on foot.
And every single freaking website reports, yeah, there's an ambient occlusion option. Yeah, it's too dark now. I can't see a damn thing. Maybe I'm not supposed to, though. Wait. Chat, what did I miss? Why am I crashed in a car?
Among Alice's things was a book.
What happened?
The Queen's Dilemma by a Dr. Emile Hartman. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice. I didn't like it. And I didn't like the
Was the cutscene really that fast of him just driving and crashing? Oh, that's the last thing he remembers. Okay. Yeah, there's like, it's pitch black now, of course. I knew it would be, because it's never accurate. The brightness settings are never accurate from this monitor. I don't know if it's just this monitor or what, but it's never accurate. That's supposed to be barely visible, and yet if I turn all the way down, I can't see the game. Like, what's the definition of barely visible?
The gas station was my best bet. They'd have a phone I could use.
Oh, see, look. Like a long hike. Ambient occlusion just bleeds through fog. It's just not good. It's just not good. It's unfortunate. Mm.
good. I gotta go pee. I feel the sliver still! God? I'm gonna just cut my finger off at this point. Like, seriously. Just gonna cut my finger off. Let's see if it generated a cat. I hate it. I hate everything about that. It literally looks like a cat with no eyes. It's like gaping eye sockets. Boy, it really just... Hey, that one's actually okay. Ah! God, I hate that one. Now we'll do dog. What if I do happy dog? What will that do? Foundry did a video on this. Oh, they did. I wonder if they mentioned the ambient occlusion. This isn't Digital Foundry. What the? Never mind.
Up a flashlight, grab a coffee thermos, and get your looks on high-end consoles like Xbox Series X, S, and Master, not a remake. Mini worked with new shaders for skin and hair, S and PS5.
Man, it really does look a lot better than the original.
Solid 60 frames per second. Let's find out. Quick word on revisiting Alan Wake, a game that made waves on Xbox 360 at the time. Arriving 7 years after Remedy's work on Max Payne 2, and Wake himself, he wakes up to what would have known as the tape, which is crucial to survive Quantum Break and in its approach to storytelling. Detailed FAQ on the project, it's very much based on the 2012 PC release balance step. The team makes it absolutely clear this is the same game, but you get all the DLC bundled in. Plus on PS5, you have adaptive trigger integration from the director Sam Lake. Plus on PS5, you have adaptive trigger integration, adding a satisfying snap to gun.
Yeah, it was showing side by side at the start.
In the no-show category, there's no high dynamic range support included, and there's no ray tracing. The package has a satisfying snap to gun trigger pulls. In the no-show category, there's no high dynamic range support included, and there's no ray tracing. The package is pretty straightforward then, but in many ways, Alan Wake holds up nicely as is with the visual changes it gets. Let's look at the remaster upgrade in comparison. We're kicking off with the now it's all 2 years later. Complex woodlands all could be some workarounds. The low native resolution of 960. The game is visibly blurry running on scenes bright. With drops below at point summary, all pretty expected for the book numbers for a second. And while we're here, let's bring in the other two next-gen machines to compare, PS5 and Series S. For Xbox Series X and PS5, the native resolution is boosted to FAA pass. Now, MSAA isn't at all common these days, especially in this age of post-processing techniques, reconstruction, and so on. But given we're using legacy code, where MSAA is a crucial part of an engine pipeline for addressing aliasing on woodland details, it makes sense to see a return. So yes, 1440p on the two top. The rest of the comparison points between the three are minimal based on close testing. Shadows, textures, lighting upgrades all benefit from the remastered in equal measure, and there isn't much to split the three consoles here. The remaster is much more than just a resolution bump, of course.
If there was ray tracing, I wouldn't need ambient occlusion.
First playing the game is in the textures and newly added objects across the environment. Texture map changes are best shown in daytime segments. Series X, an example here, has vastly higher resolution materials, and likewise across the tables of the bar, the hallways, the vehicles, everything is touched upon to better suit a 4K output. The game is veiled in darkness most of the time, and so yes, honestly, the 360 version still holds up pretty well for these early chapters at least.
It really does.
So much is hidden by darkness, but any shots of bright falls in the light of day flags 360's RAM limitations. So texture upgrades were a must, and as for the added terrain, we see it pretty much from the get-go during Alan Wake's first nightmare. New barricades are strewn across the street up front, with plenty more. Master also addresses one key limit of Alan Wake's 360 release, the low-res buffers for lighting effects and shadows. Both light and shade are dynamic, with cloud scatter visibly degraded to support a playable frame rate on 360. Light intersects with lower Xbox 3's higher res lighting buffers on Xbox 3's decks. And so it goes for the shadows as well. We have dithering on Xbox 360 for shadowed elements, but it's cleared up with a hot appearance on next-gen machines. Excellent stuff.
They're really not talking about ambient occlusion at all.
So in summary, resolutions, effects, and textures are each tailored to suit today's hardware. There's another major pillar to this remaster, though, which is the characters themselves. Character models are updated with differently dark. Pure appearance and Alan Wake even sports a thickness. Hoof and the bar both seem pretty radical version elements, of course. But which one?
Man, they really did.
Best starts to become a bit more subjective when the core design is so different from Remaster. But you can see Remedy's original framework. It seems, book speak, booking the game install from 7 on the Remaster Series FPS gameplay moves on the 360 code. We know it isn't perfect, but at 30 FPS, the original game pushed some cutting edge techniques for the time. We saw it hold 30 for reasonable stretches too, especially while exploring solo with a flat Aiken, and the frame rate does start to tumble into the 20s. Add in variable and the full game frames per second. And it must be said, a majority of the time, we are locked on that target. There are some exceptions to the 60fps line. Series X is mostly in the right place, but you will see drops under 60 points. And when it touches a tearing very, very most powerful console on the market, points to the fact this is an old engine at its core, designed for a very different era. We see the same issue on Series S as well, which runs at 1080p native rather than 1440p. Series S performance is typically great in most chapters, a largely 60fps experience in my book, but then we have set piece moments pulling it down to the same frame rate lows as Series X, with pairing almost always involving flares. Last up is the PS5 release. There isn't a huge revelation in this case, except for one point.
Well, I don't give a damn about it, man!
PS5 has no screen tearing when it drops its frame rate. So, the PS5 edition runs at the same 60fps target. When it does drop, though, expect to see marginally harder hits under 60, given these...
Oh, yeah, I'm playing a video game!
...with no way for it to render partial elements of the frame. In other words, there's simply less flexibility for when a frame can be pushed out, and as a result, frame rate drops are more easy to pick up by up. Got a rock and glistened green color in my PS5 playthrough. My game had all these parts rendered with a... Enjoy it. Aside from the rough points, in lighting, textures, and more, as does the jump to 60fps, and I look forward to your comments on 60 eras.
Right. Yeah, it's it's crazy when you look at the, the comparison shots. It really is pretty different.
Hello?
A lot of better textures.
Someone
and
there?
Models.
The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure. That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started. I was named the author. I hadn't written it. I couldn't remember writing it. In the scene on the page, the hero was attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night.
Good thing it's just on this page, and not actually real.
The man turned to face me. His face was covered in shadows. It was hard to make him out in the darkness of the forest that surrounded us, but the axe he lifted was plain to see. It glistened with the blood of his victim. He grinned madly. The shadows were alive, distorting his features. It was a scene from a nightmare, but I was awake.
Yo, hours to grab for work. Yay, I can't wait to work Sundays when I'm supposed to have it off. But I need the hours, I need the money, yippity-skippity-doo. At least I can do that now. I couldn't do it when I worked in the office because I didn't want to drive 30 minutes for a few hours here and there. That would just be a waste of gas. This looks nice. You know, another game I've been wanting to replay is Jedi Fallen Order. I prefer the camera over whichever shoulder benefits me at the moment. Actually, can I switch shoulders? Because I usually just switch depending on the situation. I don't think there is. Oh, right there. Tab. No. No. Direct aiming. What the hell does that mean? What the hell does that mean? Direct aiming. No, I want to indirectly aim. What? It was disabled. Defaulted it disabled. I'm very confused.
I've been in an accident!
An accident?
terrible, terrible accident.
Yeah, usually, like, see if I'm, like, up against a wall right here, then I'll swap shoulders so that I'm over the right shoulder. It mostly depends on the environment, geometry. See, this, the camera's obviously right here, better off on my right side because of this wall. But if there was a wall to my right side, then I'd swap it to the left side. I flip and swap like crazy in Battlefront 2.
The lights up ahead were a good sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
This game does reward exploration, doesn't it? My sensitivity is way too high. Doesn't sound like it's that big of a difference, honestly. So I guess the default's more immersive. Yeah, I thought I was thinking raw input as well, but why not just say that?
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
Accident!
Hey, you!
Phil!
There's been an accident. I need help. Listen, I need to...
Cabins for rent in
Nightfall.
Oh, hell.
Carl Stuckey.
Pleased
to meet you. Non-refundable
reservation
deposit required. Fair and square.
You're just the man I was looking for.
Fair and square.
Square and... chair. Ooh, coffee thermos. I wish I could climb over a fence, but I'm just a regular dude who doesn't know how to do basic human activities, such as climbing things.
The Taken stood before me. It was impossible to focus on it, as if it stood in a blind spot caused by a brain tumor and eye disease. It was bleeding shadows like ink underwater, like a cloud of blood from a shark bite. I was terrified. I squeezed the flashlight like my life depended on it, willing it to stop coming any closer. Suddenly something gave, and the light seemed to shine brighter.
Except you don't have a flashlight right now. The story's wrong. Where's the flashlight? But who was flashlight?
Second now, and Stucky would be knocking on the door with his axe like Nicholson in The Shining.
I mean, he literally just did The Shining thing, didn't he?
Here's Stucky!
They should have done that. It fits. Oh, I do have a flashlight. Oh, I just pick it up?
During your... trying...
See, look, they had a whole map and everything. Like, they were... This game was well underway of being an open-world game. That's why there's vehicles to drive and stuff. You were supposed to be able to drive around.
You can see the sights and keep those cholesterol levels down.
Yes.
Right.
Great Falls Sheriff Station.
How did he know the number for the sheriff station? No driver. I should have just stayed. I want to see what it looks like dying in that. That would be interesting to see. Oh, this freaking sliver is throbbing my fingers. Dad!
The bulldozer had gone over the cliff with the office. I hoped Stucky had suffered the same fate, but I wasn't planning on staying to find out.
There wasn't a driver, bro. I just looked. I saw no driver. Ah! It shocked me! Convenient doors opening for me. That's nice.
More of them.
The deaths are so dumb looking.
I never fired a gun outside a shooting range, and now I just killed someone or something. There were no bodies. They just disappeared. If I was dreaming, it felt real enough to make me sick. Eerie hand-painted graffiti was revealed by my flashlight. Someone had hidden a chest of supplies near it.
Maybe I should play a nightmare. That flipping, it's giving me resources up the ace. Aish.
The Dark Forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station.
Ew.
It's rabbit season.
Duck season! Oh, I'm on my flare! That's nice! Good wastes! Essentially using one of the most powerful weapons in the game on one enemy. So that's good.
The Taken stood before me. It was impossible to focus on it, as if it stood in a blind spot caused by a brain tumor and eye disease. It was bleeding shadows like ink underwater, like a cloud of
blood. I heard this one, excuse me. What was the new one? Oh. What?
Departure by Ellen Wake.
What?
Rose knew she had been gushing, but right now she didn't care. As far as she was concerned, her brief meeting with Alan Wake was literally the high point of her life. She watched as he got in the car with his wife. She was pretty, confident, at ease with Wake. Not like Rose. They were perfect for each other. She'd have given anything to be cool.
Doink. Apparently on Nightmare, there's more manuscripts you can collect, too. Now that I'd find them all. I swear the cutscenes ignore your audio settings, so it's just blast your ears to hell.
When I saw the river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head.
And I died. The end. Thank you for reading.
hell was that?
No, enemies do fly away when you kill them. What's bugging me is when I kill them, they suddenly pop up into the air in a standing position and then fly back. Typically, they're supposed to fly back. And, like, they'll fly up or fly back, but they like, pop up in the air. Like, it, you can tell it looks wrong when they die.
When I saw the river below...
Actually, those last few that I killed, I don't think they did it, did they? I didn't notice if they did. I don't think they did.
I have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water.
So I jumped in it. You tippy toe there.
Barry Wheeler was bouncing off the walls. He jumped on a plane after his calls were ignored by both Al and Alice for several days. It could mean that they were both on a second honeymoon, but Barry didn't buy it. Al had been way too unstable for that. Not sleeping, messed up. Barry had years of experience dealing with Alan Wake, and he couldn't ignore it. Something was wrong.
Why you make me exit out three times? Doink, doink, doink. Okay, I'm gonna pay attention, see if they pop up this time.
Stucky was still out there. In the dark, stalking me.
Stucky, Pucky, Chucky. I'm full on ammo? Alright. Wow! Normal mode just gives you freaking resources like candy, doesn't it? I shouldn't have played it on normal. No, he did do the pop-up thing. That don't look right to me. I just don't. Enemies are too easy to kill, too. Why am I playing it on normal? I'm an idiot. I seriously might restart this on Nightmare. I wish you could just select the difficulty, you know? Like any game usually allows. Want to change the difficulty? Please restart the entire game. Why, you ask?
The staircase
no particular
broken.
Reason.
I had to make my way up.
Because we're assholes.
Way. I couldn't stay here. There had to be a way to get up there.
I'm full on ammo. This is ridiculous. It is the start of the game, so maybe it gets more resource heavy. I mean, I know it does. Here's my issue. On normal, I can just kill them without even aiming. Look at this shit. Oh, I press spacebar. Nah, it's not! That ain't ain't normal. They're not supposed to do that when you kill them. They're just not. They're just not, bro. It's like, what do I do other than, like, not play the game? I just have to deal with it and complain about it a lot. Yeah, that's the issue, is they do, like, little stumbles and steps in the air. And it's clearly an animation meant for the ground. Like, it's clearly an animation that's meant to be done while they're standing on ground, not in the air. Like, they suddenly will pop up and do a stumble animation. Doesn't make sense. Someone look at gameplay of this on YouTube. Maybe it's... There's no way... That's just... Something that happens and they're like, yeah, okay. They didn't think maybe that should be fixed or anything? And I'm the only one complaining about it? I swear, it's gotta be just my game for some reason. Oh, it does adjust how many enemies and stuff. Oh. Oh. We're changing it. We're done. We're done. Oh, please reload the last thing I had. Oh, there we go. All right. I closed it, so now I don't remember what it was. It was 31... 30. Shit, there's a lot more hex code now because the save has a lot more information. Oh, you blew it, Austin. You blew it. You blew it hard. I gotta find that damn website. Oh, there it is. Okay. 303101 is what I'm looking for. 303301. It's because it's the next level. So it should be 303300. 30... Wait, let's see what that... 31 represents the game level. Oh, no, the 31 represents the game level. So I'm on level 3. 30, 33, 00. 30, 33, 01, which is normal mode. So change that to 02. And that'll be nightmare mode. That should, in theory, put the difficulty on nightmare mode. In theory. Sure, I don't know what you mean, but let's see how corrupted this save is now. That should be it, but, No. Cancel. Wait. Yeah, upload to the cloud, whatever. I hate that cloud crap. Just let me play off my machine, jeez. what difficulty you're on. I don't think it says anywhere in the game what difficulty you're playing on. That's the problem. So I'll load it up and I don't know. Is it on nightmare mode? Is it on normal mode? Nope. I'll never play Total Chaos. Deal with it. Atheists. Shit, I have no idea what the difficulty is, and there's no way to know. Maybe if I go to, like, load game, it'll show. There's no load game. Oh, God, you really just do this, huh? Well, can I do new game on Nightmare? No. So you have to edit an existing save to play on Nightmare. How do I know if it's on Nightmare? It does not unlock Nightmare mode. It just alters that save file to be Nightmare mode. So I can only just assume that it's in Nightmare mode. That's dumb that there's no way to actually look at the difficulty anywhere. There is no way to see what difficulty it is. I guess I'll just be like, is this harder now? I don't know. The statistics? Oh, I'm a dum-dum. Does not say difficulty still. That's hilarious. Hilarious that you can't see. I'll be able to know if I just encounter some enemies, I think. Damn it, it saved after I killed those guys. Wait, how do I... I guess I'll just be able to, like, count the shots. It takes, like, 3 shots on normal to kill an enemy. And yeah, it does take longer to get their shadow gone. God dang it, I missed a thermos. That's a damn shame. It's so important to get those thermoses. So important. Now I'm like... What the hell is this? File 10 failure. Open file failed. Error code 0. Alright. And the game crashed. Well, I'm thinking that XX edit broke something. Shit. Damn. I don't know what to do then. 30-33-02. 30-33-00. I was hitting a checkpoint, I think, is what caused the crash. Well, no one in the comments of this is saying that it crashes their game. Can I just download a save, or is it specific to my profile? Alan Wake Remastered. Complete game save file. If I can just get a save file... Oh! You can just download a save file. You don't need to hex edit. That's all I needed to do? Because... Usually when they hex edit, it means it's locked to your profile, so you can't just download. You have to do it on your... Alan Wake, save file. 100% save file.
Remastered. Click download. Click download. Click download. Click download. Where's download? Proof. Register or sign in to view external links. Fuck your ass. With the fucking ass. Fuck your ass. With ass. Are you serious? Someone find me a save file, stat! I can't. Like, that one thing makes... It says I have to register to their website in order to download it. Wow, that was a useful video. Thank you. I'm so glad that the thumbs up, thumbs down system is now gone, so I can just watch these stupid videos and waste my life. Oh no! What do I do? I'm not registering to this website. You can kiss mine. Wait, 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 wait. Oh, that's just... Really? I'm just looking for a save file. That's all I'm looking for. It's weird. I'm gonna go out on a limb and say that it's not linked, or that it's not, it wouldn't work. Because usually when a game lets you unlock Nightmare Mode, then there'll be plenty of save files on the internet. Oh, so it wouldn't work. So, what have we learned? I don't know. I don't know, man. What am I launching? Diablo? Why am I launching Diablo? Let's not. Oh my god, I think that's the value I changed that I shouldn't have. That's the value right there, I think. Try that one. Said World 3 next to it, so that was the one. I edited something. The thing I edited, I have no idea what it was. I think? I don't know. Here's the thing. I don't know. I'll just have to go to another checkpoint and see if it crashes again. I wish there was like a simple way to figure it out, like just by like battery usage or something. I don't know.
trigger that checkpoint, crash my effing game. This'll work. It'll work this time. Don't worry, it'll work this time. Pretty confident it'll work this time. All the confidence it'll work this time. Son of a bitch! God! Work this time. This is just to see if it'll work this time. Please don't fall. Please don't fall. I just about fell again. Here it comes. God damn it. I wish I could read this message. It's so small. I don't even know what that means. File IO failure. Cool. Cool. I need to do what it says to do originally and just start a game and then close it once the game starts. So I'll do that tomorrow and try and figure it out. Alright. Alright. Alright guys, thanks for watching. Thanks for tuning in. Oh wait, we should see what it generated. What were we looking at? We did dog. Oh yeah, smiling dog or whatever. What the hell? That worked really well. For the most part. Oh, happy dog. That one's a little creepy. That one is extremely creepy. Oh my god. Look at the tongue's coming out of the neck! It friggin' screwed up the placement of the tongue! Whoa! Yo, Kiro, eat your face! Look at it, it's got like a shark mouth. Like rows of teeth. That is horrifying. Alright, chat, have a good night. I'll see you next time. You can't see what I'm looking at. See, that's the cool thing when chat actually lets me know something like that immediately instead of, like, at the end of the stream. Look, the tongue's coming out of the neck of this one. Also, this one looks like a shark mouth. Yo, Kiro, eat your face. That's why I said that. That one's kind of weird looking. But for the most part, it's not too bad. I love that tongue just coming out of your neck. All right, now good night, chat. God. Have a good night. See you next stream. Stay safe, stay well. Oh, by the way, thank you so much, Winchesterburn, for the $50 donation. Birdman, thank you for the gifted subs. Finally Pooping, thank you for the resubs. And y'all have a good one. See you next stream. Good night. Later.